Jack Dorsey steps down as the CEO of Twitter. Now, a lot of there's no real cause as to why he stepped down, but in 2020, his board tried to force him out last year.
Okay.
But they weren't able to. But this year, he steps down. The CTO actually is the one who fills.
He looks like one of them dudes from Lord of the Rings.
Oh, because of the bit?
Yeah.
But so, you know, it's crazy because a lot of people, as much as big tech and these social media sites censor free speech, he was kind of the only one that was
ready to fight for it a little bit.
A bit. You get what I'm saying?
Right.
You could tell because once your company goes public and once you have a board of directors,
it's a wrap.
The company's not yours anymore, so
yeah,
you can't.
Yeah.
Once they want to go another direction with whatever, you have to kind of go with that, or they'll force you out.
Right, right. And that's the part of business we don't learn about.
Yes.
You know, you just think you run the business.
Yes.
But once you got these board members and they can force you out.
That's what happened to Steve Jobs.
Yes, that's what happened to Steve Jobs.
He got fired from his own company.
From his own company.
The CEO from Lululemon, the yoga pants and stuff like that. He got forced out of his whole company.
Right, but wasn't he into some weird shit?
I don't know that. I just know that part. So Jack Dorsey steps down, and people are worried that censorship now on Twitter is about to increase because the new CEO, they have him on record saying, you know, we kind of have to move past the First Amendment. We can't be bogged down by the First Amendment and have to understand that times have changed, a.k.a. PC, woke culture. You know, what they call woke culture will now start to really take over, and now censorship will be more prevalent on that app especially.
Yeah, but again, we've seen it happening over the last couple of years, mainly with this this jab situation.
Oh, man, yes.
This whole situation has revealed a lot.
Mm.
And I'm reading listening to the Fauci book.
The real Anthony Fauci.
The real Anthony Fauci by Robert
F. Kennedy
Jr. Bruh, I'm only past the intro in one chapter, and this dude is the most evil, sinister man to ever walk Earth.
You text me that. I was just like, he did something recently? Like,
bro, I mean, what he has allowed under his watch as the chief medical doctor in this country.
Yes.
Since 1984, you know, 69 shots for kids now, autoimmune diseases, fructose, all of these things that have moved us from a health. We were at the top in terms of health prior to that. Mm-hmm. We are now at the bottom. And it's all because of Big Pharma, which is now in bed with Big Tech, which is now in bed with Big Media. Those are the three super conglomerates that are now running our lives. But if you can get a chance to read or listen to this Fauci book, this dude, I mean, the IQ of our children have dropped. The suicide, death, rape, murder, molestation, depression in the last 2 years is mind-boggling. Mm. And he had the nerve or the audacity to say he didn't think past the safety. He didn't think for every cause there's an effect. And the effect of locking down regular people who had no issues caused a whole whirlwind of things, and we have not recovered. They said it'll be 15 years before we recover from this. Wow. And the transfer of wealth from the middle America, which was something like 40 trillion or billion, it was a lot of money, is the same exact number of money made by Bill Gates, by Bezos, by all of them. So the transfer of wealth from the middle class to the upper class, dude, this is some crazy stuff.
And with that that intro, because I listened to it, what that shows you is like who is the real power in this country. So we think of power, we think of a president, we think of, you know, somebody in government in other countries, prime minister and these things like that. But when you realize who can control policy, because now, you know, it's a medical emergency, so now the head medical person is the most powerful person in the world right now. He's the most powerful person in the world. I mean, in the country, at least.
Yes.
Along with Bill Gates, who can kind of tell him what to say. And
Well, you follow the money, and the FDA gets so much money from Big Pharma. They all get so much money from Big Pharma that it's like a contradiction.
Mm-hmm.
How can you go against something that's paying you as much as it's paying you? This is crazy.
Yeah.
So democracy as we know it is shot.
Yeah, sadly.
And me and you spoke before we got on air. Knowledge is one thing. Knowing that you're living a lie every single day when you wake up, do you know what that does to your soul and your spirit? Because what you're telling me overall is, do not believe what I see, I hear, and I feel intuitively. You're telling me to believe you. And what you're saying is not even matching up. This shit is like playing fucking cards. With two cards that match the same. What game is that we used to play?
Three Card Monty?
No, the two cards, two color cards.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
But you know what I'm saying? Yeah, like the two cards should match for this shit to make sense. And I got a king and a jack, and you telling me to move forward.
Peace. If you like what you just saw and would love to see more of the uncut, unscripted, unadulterated, spontaneous, off-the-rip information from me and Brother Malcolm, you need to become a member. Hit that link below because we're going to be going in on the after show.
And we have more exclusive content as well, so don't forget to hit that link. Peace.